Bravo 851, turn right, heading 180. Bravo 14 Papa, turn right 245. Report localizer established 27.
Everyone, welcome back to DJ's Aviation. One of the most talked about engines in the aviation industry today is the Trent 1000. You could say that it is rightly so, considering the almost never-ending problems impacting the type, and therefore operators with Package B and Package C engines. Now, with Singapore Airlines reporting the exact same premature blade deterioration on their own Trent 1010s, which was found on the Trent 1000s, it is about time I take a look in a combined video some of the other problems surrounding engines within the aviation industry, from other manufacturers as well. Publishing a video a day, and sometimes two, means keeping up with all the content can definitely be hard, and I'm aware of that. If you've been with the channel for a very long time, though, and managed to watch every single upload, you may have noticed that I touched on Pratt & Whitney, but never really got to General Electric, a company which many in the comments have said is the answer to the Trent 1000 problems. The GE-NX engine, similar to the Trent 1000, features on the Boeing 787 series. What's also similar is that the GE-NX has also had its fair share of problems, albeit not featured as prominently on the channel. Back in 2014, a Boeing 787 with Japan Airlines was struck with an in-flight shutdown after an oil pressure alert. This followed a string of incidents with the GE-NX engine on the 787, with another Japan Airlines aircraft some 2 years later facing another in-flight shutdown. However, this time, it was during a flight through icy conditions. The ice didn't just impact the 787, though, with an Airbridge Cargo 7478 freighter facing a similar situation where it suffered icing in the engines at high altitudes. To simplify, the GE-NX-1B engine had a software bug which saw, in a particular instance, the computer to shut down the engine during a climb to higher altitude in these icy conditions. Back in June of 2018, General Electric were working tirelessly to fix this software bug, as they were not going to be able to obtain an airworthiness to power the 787-10, which is something that's obviously critical to them. Moving along, though, to Pratt & Whitney, Indigo and Go Air, who operate in the complete polar opposite conditions to that of some of the carriers I just mentioned, saw engine vibrations occur in 2018. The PW1100Gs were experiencing vibrations at a high power setting during the climb phase. This meant that engine replacements were required, and if you were on the channel, you may have seen that it did leave a number of carriers like Lufthansa and Indigo impacted, with Indigo having to ground a number of the type. Before this incident, though, the type was impacted by its knife edge seal. Pratt & Whitney attempted to fix this problem by a new improved and also approved design, which began deliveries to customers 1 month after the first knife edge seal problem was found. Ultimately, Rolls-Royce is not the only engine manufacturer which has faced problems, and while there's certainly a big focus on the channel, partly due to just how interested I know you all are in the engine manufacturer, it is once in a blue moon worth mentioning that other engine manufacturers are not immune to problems either. With all that being said, General Electric, Pratt & Whitney, and even Rolls-Royce have still received countless orders and are delivering engines to customers at an incredible rate. This is all to help deal with the backlog of orders for Boeing and Airbus, which stretch to some 9 years. With that being said, thank you very much for watching this video of mine. Engines are certainly not something I'm that experienced in or have that much knowledge on. However, through reading and research, it is hopefully something that eventually I will get to know more on. Thanks very much for watching another one of my videos, and I do look forward to you all joining me in the next one. The night, race all of these broken dreams in flight. And we'll fly.